In Russia, the number of mobilized people who refuse to fight against Ukraine is growing, so Vitaly Dzhunkovsky and Ivan Tarasov, sentenced to 2 years and 8 months in a colony at the end of August this year, did not try to evade service for the first time. In October last year, they filed a report refusing to participate in the war. Later in April and May 2023, the mobilized 3 times refused to return to the front, explaining their decision also with a lack of preparation.
Of course, we see serious problems, firstly with the number of people at the front. Secondly, we see that the government is trying to somehow solve it. In particular, over the past few months, a few strange situations has developed. The authorities diligently raised the punishment and terms, which rely on the desertion from the unit and failure to follow orders.
Amendments to the Russian Criminal Code provide for 3 to 10 years in prison for refusing to take part in hostilities. The increase in the term of punishment, as well as the transfer of authority to capture deserters to the Federal Security Service, indicates that things are not going well in the ranks of the Russian army. There are fewer and fewer people who want to go to certain death, experts say. However, cases against deserters are opened reluctantly.
Secondly, these proceedings are initiated with real difficulty, and they beat around the bush as much as possible. They do not want to initiate proceedings. Why? Because they are persistently suggesting to people who left the unit to return, take up arms and go to the front.
Citizens of the Federation not only do not want to carry out the criminal orders of the military command, but often do not want to return home from Ukrainian captivity.
Some prisoners ask the Ukrainian authorities to delay their exchange until after their military contracts have expired, so that they are not compelled to fight again. A few ask not to be returned at all. But then they have to remain in custody until the war is over, The Economist publication writes.
Captured Russian soldiers are asked not to hurry with the exchange because they do not want to be at the front again. Many fear that they can simply be killed at home, and some are afraid to surrender because of the intimidation of the Kremlin authorities.
There is a very, very strong fear, not to mention the fact that the word captivity, of course, sounds dangerous for any mobilized. Contract soldier, conscript, anyone.
The Russian military is trying to avoid combat by any means necessary. So on August the 10th, the 26-year-old Russian lieutenant Ivan Korolev, who refused to serve in the Russian army, crossed the border between Russia and Lithuania and asked for political asylum. The man said he did not want to participate in a bloody war. Reported by Diana Kolesnik, Yulia Granovska, UATV News.